possible that he died towards the early morning hours of November 19th, having had taken a turn for the worst. The idea that Ainz fell ill to indigestion and later died from heart failure has always been scrutinized over the years. In fact, there are just too many conflicting reports in regards to that scenario that it raises suspicions even more. So, let's begin with the conspiracy theories. The first thing that people may be not aware of is Hearst's involvement with this woman, Marion Davies. Not only was she his, I guess, primary mistress, he developed an entire studio to build up her career so that she could star in all of the movies. So, although they never married, they apparently did have a love child, and there was just, you know, I guess a certain amount of possessiveness that he felt for her. Now, Hearst owned a large portion of the newspapers that would publish around the country. However, there were obviously rivals, and he didn't have a complete monopoly in the media. So, some opposing newspapers, or ones that were not owned by him, did publish photographs of Marion Davies with Charlie Chaplin, claiming that there was some inappropriate behavior between the two of them. Now, whether that was true or not is questionable just to begin with, but let's see what the article says and then I'll comment afterwards. The most popular rumors was that Hearst invited Charlie Chaplin as one of his guests that weekend to observe Chaplin with Hearst's mistress, actress Marion Davies. The rival newspapers of Hearst's empire had published accounts just a week prior to the trip, stating that Davies and Chaplin were seen together in an inappropriate manner. Perhaps Hearst wanted to see for himself and had invited Chaplin to find out if the rumors were true. He had to know if his beloved mistress, Marion, was being unfaithful or not. As the rumors go, Chaplin and Davies had been seen below by Hearst. They were below deck conversing. Eventually, Chaplin left his hat and retreated back to his stateroom for the night. In a jealous rage, Hearst went back to his stateroom and retrieved his diamond-studded revolver that he was most famously known for shooting down seagulls with, and went back to where Davies and Chaplin had been seated. Somewhere during W.R.'s stroll to retrieve his gun, Ainz had gone up and found Davies alone. What they were talking about is unknown to this day, but the outcome proved to be fatal. Some rumors state that Ainz picked up Chaplin's hat and put it on as a joke to Davies. As they sat there chatting, mistaken for Chaplin, Hearst shot Ainz in the back of the head, and feeling so overcome by guilt for shooting the wrong person, Hearst swore everyone on the yacht to secrecy, probably buying them off, and covered the whole story up. Another theory in regards to the whole Chaplin-Davies-Hearst love triangle was that there was a fight and that Hearst flat out shot at Chaplin and missed, and then the bullet somehow exited the porthole and struck Ainz in the forehead while he was strolling on deck. Another said that Ainz was trying to break up the fight between Chaplin and Hearst while the gun went off, striking him in the head. No matter which theory you choose in the category, Hearst seems to be the shooter in these scenarios. The incident of self-defense. Now, this is where it gets kind of interesting as a sort of beeline story, but I think it actually might be the more significant aspect to this. Okay, so remember that Marion Davies had a secretary. Her name was Abigail Kinsolving, and Kinsolving was on the boat as well. It's just that she wasn't registered as a guest because I guess she was her secretary. So, Kinsolving was pregnant, and she was also the mistress, or I guess fling, maybe not full-time mistress, of Ainz, for goodness sake. So, Science is on board. This Secretary of Davies is pregnant with apparently his child, and there is, you know, a potential for some sort of rigmarole. So this is it's a strange beeline story because nothing was ever proven, and the story that came out of the that came out of this doesn't really check out. But if you look at the post events of what happened, something did happen. It's just not clear what. So it starts like this. So in another quite messy scenario is that of an unknown character, Abigail Kinsolving. Miss Kinsolving happened to be Miss Davies' secretary, and from the most stories that she is not among those listed being aboard the Oneida that night. However, apparently, through the gossip circuit, the story claims that Abigail was attacked by Ines aboard her yacht, and that she shot him in self-defense, or even stabbed him. Another report states that she only admitted to being attacked, but never mentioned anything about how he died, or even if the death was related to the attack. Stories go on to state that Abigail became pregnant from that instant and gave birth to a daughter, Louise, just months later. So, as you know, pregnancies take 9 months, so for her to give birth just a few months later sounds fishy. Also, the reports claim that Ines attacked her on Saturday night of the 15th, which is impossible because Ines didn't even board the Oneida until Sunday morning, and he had been busy at the premiere of The Mirage and had been photographed, and he wasn't on board at the time that she claims this, and it doesn't even really make sense why this was even claimed, other than it's quite possible that this was an initial attempt to cover up the Hearst shooting story, that, you know, maybe trying to push the story in a separate direction. Anyway, now if she wanted to claim that Ines was the father of her baby, who I'm now assuming that she was already expecting long before stepping foot on the Oneida, perhaps she was enraged with jealousy when she saw that Hearst had invited Ines's main mistress at the time, named Margaret Livingston. This is her picture. And her, in her delicate condition, you know, was beyond livid at that point, and then shot him in some fit of anger. There are so many possibilities to the scenarios behind the Abigail Kinsolving theory. If she was, in fact, having a sexual relationship with Ines prior to the yacht trip, she could have confided in him that she was pregnant with his child, and he could have said it wasn't his, and that he wouldn't leave his wife for her. Perhaps he was just a fling to Ines, although it might have meant much more to her. Again, there really is no way to know if Ines was secretly seeing Abigail or not, but had she really been pregnant with his child and become so enraged at the sight of Livingston, or upset that Ines refused to acknowledge her pregnancy, she could have lost it that night and shot him herself. It would be very easy for her to claim that she was attacked, but the whole thing never came to any resolution. Also, think about this. Marion Davies was everything to Hearst, and she spent a lot of time with Davies, so it would be a major scandal for Davies if something like this had happened, and Hearst might have covered up the story for Davies' sake, possibly. It's interesting. The interesting point about this that I find interesting is that Abigail died shortly after giving birth to her daughter Louise, and her body was found among the wreckage of an auto accident near La Cuesta Encantada, Hearst's ranch in San Simeon. Allegedly, Hearst's bodyguards discovered her body, where they also found a suicide note. Many speculated that the note was written by two different people, given the two distinct sets of handwriting on the note, so the whole story is very bizarre. This lady, you know, just a few months later gives birth to a some sort of situation ensued, whether it was the secretary who shot him or Hearst. It seems like Ines was shot, and it was because of this pregnancy. And, you know, not only was the situation covered up very quickly, the fact that the woman died and then was, you know, buried with this bizarre suicide note, it's just very strange. I think that that's actually the secret key to this case. But we don't have any, you know, major information on it because it's all been lost basically by this point. So there's no way to determine whether both sets of writing were from Abigail or someone else. As the story goes, after Abigail died, Marion Davies quickly took Louise and placed her in an orphanage that Davies financially supported, making sure that Louise would be taken care of. More proof of Hearst's capability to cover over concealed secrets was one that he held on to the grave. Okay, so this is just a side story, and I'll just pass over it, but this is apparently the love child between Marion Davies and Hearst named Patricia Van Cleve. So, you know, it really doesn't have anything to do with this direct story. They only mentioned it because it was a cover-up that had lasted for so many years, meaning that Hearst could cover up any kind of story he wanted to, which obviously is true. So now back to the Ines situation. There was no autopsy done, which is bizarre. You know, there should be an autopsy report, but according to the papers, Wednesday morning's edition of the Los Angeles Times revealed a headline was that movie producer was shot on Hearst's yacht. So this was published that, you know, so if there was nothing to do with a gunshot, why would the Los Angeles Times publish that as their initial, you know, as their initial headline? But by the afternoon edition, that headline had been pulled with any other information in regards to Ines's injuries, and one of Hearst's own papers had even published a headline reading, "Special car rushes a stricken man from the ranch, not from the boat." In fact, at first Hearst wanted the public to think that Ines was actually at his ranch in San Simeon, and that he was rushed home when he felt ill, but the rumors got out that people knew he had boarded the Oneida that Sunday morning, and the papers had to backpedal where the story had to change quickly. Then the story claimed that Ines fell ill due to ulcers and indigestion from eating salted almonds on board the ship, and that caused a heart attack 2 days later, which doesn't make any sense. When Ines died at his home in Benedict Canyon, his personal physician, Dr. Glasgow, signed the death certificate stating that the cause of death was heart failure. Ines was shot or became ill on Sunday evening, departed from the yacht early Monday. He died on the 19th, and the funeral took place 2 days later. And upon those present were Marion Davies, Charlie Chaplin, Ines's brother Ralph, and John, accompanied by Eleanor Ornell, his wife, and their three sons. There were several other celebrities there as well. Ines' remains were cremated immediately, so no autopsy and cremation. Also, his remains are nowhere to be found, even to this day, even the cremated remains. But records state that even though he was cremated, the record states, like in the newspapers, that it was an open casket ceremony, which wasn't the case at all. And they even had two officers testify that they had checked Ines' head for what reason, if he wasn't shot, if he died from indigestion. Why are these guys signing papers saying that his head was totally fine? I mean, I think they just didn't know what to do, so they had all of these angles, you know, attempting to cover up right at the time. So then we come over here. So what about the witnesses? So none of the witnesses were actually questioned by the police, which again, that just proves that Hearst is able to control the situation. The only person that was questioned was this doctor that was Hearst's studio head, who had escorted Ince back to his ranch, or to the hotel and then to his ranch, whatever the case may be. Mary and Dave is okay. The other weird thing is that all of the people started lying about their whereabouts. Mary and Davies claimed that Nell Ince called her from the studio on Monday, letting her know that Thomas had died. But Ince died on Wednesday, so that wasn't true. Charlie Chaplin stated that he was never on board the Oneida that night or that weekend. And Hearst and Davies came to see Ince at his home a week after he had fallen ill. We also went on to state that he didn't die until 2 weeks later, which is again false because Chaplin was present at Ince's funeral that same week, so he knew that Ince had died just days after this boat trip. So, you know, why is Charlie Chaplin lying so much? Then you have Luella Parsons, who is that gossip columnist, and she claims that she wasn't even in California at the time, and that she was in New York when Ince had become ill and died, and people had seen her there. Vera Burnett, who was the stand-in for Mary and Davies at the studio, saw Luella and Marilyn at the studio that day and were planning the trip. So, you know, all of these people just didn't want to be a part of it. I think probably this witness is the most significant. Another witness that many have ignored over the years is the account of Chaplin's driver, Torrecio Cono, who claimed that he actually saw Ince being transported by ambulance off the yacht. Cono confided the strange account to his wife that it appeared as if Ince's head was bleeding from a bullet wound. Among the domestic workers in Hollywood and Beverly Hills, this rumor spread quickly, and in a matter of the days, there were several calls to Los Angeles authorities, as well as the authorities of San Diego, asking them to investigate Ince's death, if not for murder, then for the illegal alcohol consumption, which would have also led to the possible illness. But basically, he was shot, and they tried to cover up who shot him. Now, who was the culprit? Was it Hearst, or was it this Livingston woman, this Kensington woman? I think it was, and her involvement is significant somehow. I just feel that the fact that she died so soon after, and that the child was taken care of by Davies, I mean, there's just a lot going on here. The other weird thing is that Hearst took care of Nell Ince, the wife of Thomas Ince. So Thomas was actually pretty wealthy. He died a millionaire, and the wife did have control of the property, but Hearst bought her two hotels over the course of her life for no particular reason. These were like very famous chateau kind of hotels that people would have these extended living situations in, and he bought two of them for her. So she was taking care of her entire life as well, again, probably just to keep everything quiet because she must have found out what had happened. There would be no reason for that much effort being made if you know, this guy had not been shot, possibly by mistake, and I think that's probably what happened. So in part two, they really didn't discuss that much more. They were talking more about what I just mentioned, of how Hearst was taking care of Nell Ince's financial situation, and but strangely, in his newspapers, he published that she had gone to Europe right after the death, and had died in poverty, which wasn't the case, because he had bought her these two hotels, and she was living pretty nicely. So it's a very strange kind of case. I'm going to see if I can get back to any photographs. So this one was just the daughter. That's its own weird story, but it's just that she was the love child and had been raised by a separate family and so forth. This is Ince's mistress. I think we saw this picture. She really didn't directly have anything to do with it unless she was the cause, the secret cause of the other woman, Davis's secretary, freaking out. mistress of all people. And then the fact that she was a grown woman, it wasn't his particular interest. He was always involved with these much younger girls. And the fact that Marion Davies was photographed at a party that was at photographers from rival newspapers. This is all very suspicious. I think that Davies wanted to get photographed by those rival newspapers, and she knew that Hearst would see it, and she chose a sort of big, person, like Chaplin, who probably was not, whether he was privy to this or not, I doubt it, but according to the other articles, she was just, the inappropriate behavior was the drinking, and she was supposedly falling all over the place, and he was catching her, and that's what they had photographs of, and that's what was published, and I think it was done purposefully. I think she was acting, and I think she knew that if those get published, Hearst would see it and then get jealous and, you know, do whatever it was that she apparently wanted. She might, you know, have a leg up because she, I guess, wanted some sort of attention from him. I do believe that the photographs of Chaplin and Marion Davies were a little bit of a contrived thing by Davies. Now, the second part of this story is weird. Her secretary, this Kensington woman, that I just feel is the most significant part of this story. The fact that Hearst designed this yacht party for Ainz's birthday, and Hearst would know that Marion Davies' secretary was involved with Ainz because, like I said, he's involved with everything that Davies is doing, so he knows the secretary, and he would know if she's having an affair with this director who's working in for all of these pictures that he's involved with, because he would be coming over, there would be a whole situation. So probably he knew that the woman was pregnant, and possibly this was to confront Ainz. This whole situation might have been for that reason. I don't know why the other mistress was called, though. That doesn't totally make sense either. But some situation was going on that has to do with the secretary. Now, the fact that the secretary has this bizarre beeline story of being attacked, I feel that Hearst put her up to saying that. I don't think that she was attacked that night. First of all, Ainz wasn't even on board at the time that she claimed, so she even gave the wrong date. And it just doesn't totally make sense why that would even happen. There could have been an altercation between them of some kind, like a fight based on this possible pregnancy and whatever. And it's very possible that she shot Ainz, and this Hearst apparently maybe tried to cover it up to protect Marion Davies's reputation. And the only possible, the thing that sort of links that is the fact that this secretary died right after giving birth and was found in a shipping yard or whatever, right next to Hearst's ranch. He was somehow involved in getting rid of the secretary. The secretary had information. Either she was a witness, who I don't think she would be silly enough to talk against Hearst, or she was the murderer, and Hearst wanted to get rid of her. Why would she be killed afterwards? And she was clearly killed. I don't think it was a suicide. Two different handwritings and all of this business. And then the question of why is Marion Davies even getting involved with this woman's pregnancy afterwards and paying for her daughter's, paying for her care for the rest of her life? There is some other situation going on. It's possible that Hearst even had an affair with this Kensington woman. It's possible that Louise, the child, was Hearst's child, and they wanted Ainz to take the blame. He didn't want to do it, and somehow he was shot. There are a lot of possibilities here, but I just feel that the Ainz Okay, guys, I hope you enjoy.